Hey guys, how's it going? Capcom has been doing a great job reviving its classic franchises like Resident Evil, bringing modern gameplay and incredible graphics thanks to the RE engine. And after the remakes of RE2 and RE3, many fans were excited for a long-awaited title, Resident Evil Code Veronica. However, the remake didn't come and instead we got the announcement of RE4, leaving many fans frustrated. But when the game was released, it was an absolute success. But what about Code Veronica? Will we see a remake soon? Well, while we wait, many of us resort to emulation to relive this classic. And that's exactly what we're going to talk about today. What's the best platform to play RE Code Veronica nowadays? And what are the differences between the original version and the HD version? If you like this type of content, don't forget to click like. And if you like comparison between emulators and news, don't forget to subscribe to the channel for new videos.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
Well, regarding the differences between the two versions, the HD version brings high-definition graphics, more detailed character models, better special effects, and some improvements in gameplay, such as a new aiming system and the option to switch between classic and modern controls. Additionally, the HD version includes a training mode that is not available in the original version. The HD version features some additional scenes that were not present in the original version. These scenes help expand the game's story, and there are also achievements and trophies that are not available in the original version. For those who don't know, Dolphin is considered the best emulator for GameCube and Wii, being a reference in the emulator universe today. It is extremely solid and offers an incredible experience in terms of visual resources and graphic fidelity. However, when it comes to the game RE Code Veronica, Dolphin can deliver one of the worst experiences to the user. One of the main problems is related to the storage capacity of the GameCube disc, which is only 1.5 GB. For comparison purposes, a normal PlayStation 2 disc could have almost 3 times the capacity, reaching 4.3 GB. As the game was sold on 2 discs to deliver all FMVs, Claire's clothing textures are very difficult to decipher, even today. This is due to texture compression, which occurs due to the low storage capacity. Additionally, controls respond worse when emulated. Buttons are in random places, which can cause you to press the wrong button, accidentally open the menu, and have difficulty controlling the character, who seems quite heavy. It may take some time to get used to the controls. Another problem with Dolphin is related to the cheat to play in widescreen. The screen does not become truly complete, and it is possible to notice that some objects are not rendered in the extended area. However, where Dolphin shines is in its performance, which is excellent and leaves the system practically idle while running the game, even in high resolutions. There is also a texture pack that fixes the problem with low-resolution textures. To use it in Dolphin, it is recommended to use an SSD. Key points of Dolphin. Great performance on low-end PCs, various APIs. Android version. Limited disk capacity. Confusing controls. Widescreen cheats are not perfect. Low-resolution textures, which can be resolved with texture packs. Let's now talk about the Dreamcast version. In my opinion, Flycast is the best emulator to play Dreamcast in high resolution. If you still have doubts about which emulator to use, I'll leave a video in the card to help you choose. Just like in Dolphin, Flycast runs the game accurately, presenting excellent graphics and consuming less hardware resources. However, the textures are still very pixelated due to the use of GDRAM media, which could only store up to 1 GB per disc. But, since the game was originally designed for this console, it seems that the textures are sharper than in the GameCube version. I'll even leave a side-by-side comparison for you to check.
Sorry about that little misunderstanding, but I thought you were another one of those monsters.
Shut up! Make one wrong move and I'll shoot!
Relax, beautiful. I said I was sorry. My name's Steve.
Controls in Flycast are more responsive and less confusing than in the GameCube version, but there is still a feeling that the character is heavy to control. There are also problems with the widescreen cheat, causing objects in extended areas not to be rendered correctly. Unfortunately, I couldn't locate a texture pack for Dreamcast. However, if you want to use one, I recommend the paid version of the ReDream emulator, which allows the use of custom textures along with high resolution. Key points of Flycast. Great performance on low-end PCs. Supports various APIs. Android version available. Limited capacity of Dreamcast discs. Widescreen cheap, not perfect. Now let's analyze the PCSX2 version, which is considered one of the best standard versions to play Resident Evil Code Veronica. Unlike Dolphin, here the buttons are located in the correct places, and even the HD version used the same PlayStation 2 standard, making the experience more intuitive. The shadow and lighting system is good for the time it was released, but the PlayStation 2's gray color palette gives the game a more depressive feel. Personally, I prefer to play with a bit more contrast when it comes to darker or grayer games on the PlayStation 2, in order to compensate for this limitation in the color palette. The controller is quite responsive for a game of this era. Obviously, if we compare it to Capcom's new game standard, it still seems dated, but after all, the game was first released in 2000, almost 25 years ago. The character is still a bit heavy, but not as much as in the GameCube and Dreamcast version. PlayStation 2 widescreen cheats work very well in this title, allowing every element of the game to be rendered correctly, even in larger areas. The community provides translated, dubbed, and subtitled versions of the game. In versions that were not produced natively by Capcom, such as the Brazilian Portuguese one. In addition, there are texture packs available. Compared to Dolphin, even if you install textures on an external hard drive, they are loaded correctly, without any stuttering. Below, we will leave a comparison of the game without texture packs versus the version with texture packs, as well as a comparison of Dolphin's texture packs compared to PCSX2's. Key points of PCSX2. Excellent performance. Various APIs. Android version. Better control system in the standard version. Perfect widescreen cheat. Limited color palette. Now, let's talk about the HD versions and start with the PlayStation 3 version. The first thing that stands out is the dynamic lighting and shadows present in this version. With the lighter in hand, you can clearly see that the light follows you, instead of just reflecting on walls like in the standard version. The control scheme is identical to the PlayStation 2 version, but the character seems to be faster, making it much easier to evade an enemy attack and deal damage to multiple enemies simultaneously with just the standard weapon. The game has native widescreen support, so there are no concerns about objects being outside the rendering area. There's also a grainy noise filter, which gives the game the look of an old film, a great addition, in my opinion. RPCS3 doesn't require any advanced configuration to run this game. You can even increase the internal resolution without a significant impact on performance. However, not everything is perfect. Some areas appear very dark due to the added filters. On some occasions, I could only see the herbs because I already knew their location. Perhaps increasing the brightness can improve your experience in this aspect. The addition of filters also increases aliasing, and even by increasing the internal resolution, it wasn't possible to improve the graphics quality. Key points of RPCS3. Good performance. Excellent control system. Responsive character to commands. Additional filters. Excessive darkness. Too many jaggies, aliasing. Finally, let's talk about the HD version of Resident Evil Code Veronica on the Xenia Xbox 360 emulator. Although still in the experimental phase, the Xenia emulator offers a gameplay experience inferior to the previously mentioned versions. Unfortunately, the new HD filters do not work correctly, and dynamic lighting seems to be worse than on consoles where this technique was not used. The controls work the same way as on RPCS3, but at times I found it difficult to aim, which did not happen on the aforementioned emulators. Additionally, the HD version has excessive darkness and other unwanted effects. The only advantage of Xenia over RPCS3 is the absence of jagged edges, thanks to the Xbox 360's native anti-aliasing system. However, this is a minimal improvement and does not make up for the other deficiencies of the emulator. Unless you are conducting experimental tests, we do not recommend playing Resident Evil Code Veronica on the Xenia emulator. It is better to use one of the previous versions mentioned. Key points of Xenia. Decent performance. Excellent control system. Decent anti-aliasing. Responsive character to commands. Excessive darkness. Filters not working properly. Broken lighting effects. And so we conclude the analysis of Resident Evil Code Veronica versions on emulators. each one with its advantages and disadvantages, it's up to you to choose the one that best suits your preferences. We hope it has been helpful, and until next time.